I think that 30% of your answer in time of mini exam, that is topography of upper extremity. Another 30% that is topography of lower extremity. And 40% all in other muscles. Now, we start from shoulder girdle. Here it is, we have axillary cavity. Here it is, axillary cavity. Living man, under the hand, we have axillary fossa, but if you remove skin, subcutaneous fat, and lymph nodes, we will see axillary cavity. This cavity has four walls. Anterior wall, that is what? What is it, this muscle? Major and musculus pectoralis minor. These two muscles, minor, musculus pectoralis minor and musculus pectoralis major. And anterior wall has three triangles. First triangle between clavicle and musculus pectoralis minor, that is trigonum clavi pectorale. In projection of musculus pectoralis minor, trigonum pectorale, and below, from lower body of musculus pectoralis minor to lower body of musculus pectoralis major, trigonum subpectorale. In these three triangles, axillary artery pass. And when you will study branches of axillary artery, that is axillary artery, it pass in three triangles and gives branches in these three triangles. Next, posterior wall of axillary cavity, that is musculus, help me, subscapularis, then musculus teres major and musculus latissimus dorsi. And posterior wall has two openings, foramen quadrilaterum and foramen trilaterum. Foramen quadrilaterum, just a moment. It is not so clear to see this nerve. You can see nervus axillaris, axillary nerve, this one, that is axillary nerve. And this artery, arteria circumflexa humeri posterior, both of them goes into quadrilateral foramen, and trilateral foramen is here. In a minute, I draw diagram and explain these two openings on diagram. Middle wall of axillary fossa. Who can answer? What is the name of this muscle? Very good. Musculus serratus anterior and lateral wall humerus together with triceps. Musculus triceps brachii. They are four walls of axillary cavity and necessary to know three triangles on anterior wall and two openings on posterior wall. Next. The same we have sulcus, help me. What is this sulcus? Between this muscle. No.
Pectoralis deltoideo.
Deltoideo pectoralis. Sulcus deltoideo pectoralis is between deltoid muscle and musculus pectoralis major. In brachial region, we have two grooves. These two grooves in both sides from biceps. That is a bicep. Musculus biceps brachii. And what is this muscle? Musculus brachialis. And now, medially from biceps, between biceps and musculus brachialis, we have sulcus bicipitalis medialis. And laterally, sulcus bicipitalis lateralis. Both of these grooves are between biceps and musculus brachialis. And here it is, you can see a lot of vessels and nerves in sulcus bicipitalis medialis. All of these nerves and some vessels pass in sulcus bicipitalis medialis, most of them. And only one vein pass in sulcus bicipitalis lateralis, that is cephalic vein, it pass in sulcus bicipitalis lateralis. And one canal we have, here it is. This canal is between triceps and humerus. And radial nerve, that is radial nerve, goes into this canal. That is canalis humera muscularis, humera between humerus and triceps muscle, that is humera muscularis, or another name, canalis nervi radialis, because radial nerve passed through this canal. That is all in shoulder region. Now, forearm. In the forearm, we can see three grooves on anterior surface. First groove between, help me, musculus brachioradialis and musculus flexor carpi radialis. And name of this groove is sulcus radialis. And radial artery pass through this groove. That is sulcus radialis. Next groove is sulcus medianus, between musculus flexor carpi radialis and musculus flexor digitorum superficialis. And nervus medianus pass in this groove. And last groove is sulcus ulnaris, between musculus flexor carpi ulnaris and musculus flexor digitorum superficialis. And here it is ulna nav nervus ulnaris and the same artery, arteria ulnaris pass. Not found. Here it is, maybe broken. That is sulcus ulnaris. Next. Maybe you remember ligament which is between eminentia carpi radialis and eminentia carpi ulnaris, retinaculum flexorum. And between this retinaculum and bones of the hand, we have three canals. Largest canal, that is canalis carpi or canalis carpalis, as you want, carpi or carpalis. Another two canals, canalis carpi radialis, here it is, canalis carpi radialis, and canalis carpi ulnaris. In first canal, canalis carpi radialis, we have one tendon, that is tendon of musculus flexor carpi radialis. It passed through this canal. In canalis carpi, we have four tendons of musculus flexor digitorum superficialis, four tendons of musculus flexor digitorum profundus, and one tendon of musculus flexor pollicis longus. That is why, how many tendons of muscles in this canal?
Eight.
Four of superficial flexor, four of deep flexor, and one tendon of musculus flexor pollicis longus. And in last canal, canalis carpi ulnaris has only vessels and nerves. Here it is palmar branch of ulna nav and arteria ulnaris the same. And in dorsal surface, we have six canals under the retinaculum extensorum. Retinaculum extensorum, that is fascia. And this fascia attached to radius and to ulna and has septum which separates space under the retinaculum extensorum into six canals. And necessary to know which muscles, tendon of muscles, pass in which canal. For example, in first canal, here it is first canal, it has two tendon of musculus. Musculus abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis, both of them in first canal. In second canal, another two muscles, musculus extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis. These two muscles, a tendon of these two muscles, pass in second canal. In third canal, only one tendon of musculus extensor. Pollicis longus. This muscle pass in third canal under the retinaculum extensorum. In fourth canal, musculus extensor digitorum and musculus extensor indicis. In fifth canal, extensor digiti minimi. And in sixth canal, musculus extensor carpi ulnaris. Now, let's go to my table. For your understanding, you don't need to draw next time. Posterior wall of axillary cavity. That is scapula. Here it is humerus. And all anterior surface of scapula closed with the help of musculus subscapularis. Start from fossa subscapularis and attached to lesser tubercle minus of humerus. That is musculus subscapularis. Below of this muscle, we have musculus teres major, and teres major attached to crista tuberculi minoris, musculus teres major. Below that is the same heat is latissimus dorsi, but it's not participate in openings, in foramen trilaterum and quadrilaterum. But this one is triceps, long head of triceps, and long head of triceps attached to tuberculum infraglenoidale of scapula. And now we receive two openings. Here it is. This one is foramen quadrilaterum, and this one is foramen trilaterum. Both of these openings has superior wall, that is musculus subscapularis, inferior wall, that is musculus teres major, and in foramen trilaterum, lateral wall is long head of triceps. In foramen quadrilaterum, long head of triceps, it is middle wall, and lateral wall, that is humerus. More exact, sagittal neck of the humerus. That is all about posterior wall of axillary cavity. Anterior wall, that is clavicle, here it is clavicle, and here it is musculus, how to draw, that is a sternum. Heat is sternum, that is clavicle, and this muscle is musculus pectoralis, major, not so beautiful, but, and below of musculus pectoralis major we have musculus pectoralis minor, below of pectoralis major. These two muscles on anterior wall of axillary cavity, and space between superior border of musculus pectoralis minor and clavicle, this triangle that is number one, that is trigonum clavi pectorale. In projection of musculus pectoralis minor, number two, that is trigonum pectorale, and from lower border of musculus pectoralis minor to lower border of musculus pectoralis major, that is third triangle, that is trigonum subpectorale. Anterior wall consists of two muscles, pectoralis major and minor, and between these two muscles we have three triangles, trigonum clavi pectorale, pectorale and subpectorale. That is anterior wall of axillary cavity. And now, some words about canals under the retinaculum flexorum and extensorum. Here it is. That is eminence carpi radialis, and here it is eminence carpi ulnaris. Between them we have retinaculum flexorum, and this retinaculum attached to this eminence with the help of two branches and makes canalis carpi ulnaris. Here it is canalis carpi radialis, and here it is canalis carpi or canalis carpalis. Look here, canalis carpi radialis, canalis carpi ulnaris, and here it is canalis carpalis or canalis carpi. In first canal, here it is only one tendon of musculus flexor carpi radialis. In this canal only vessels on nerve. And in canalis carpi we have four tendons of superficial flexor, musculus flexor digitorum superficialis, four tendons of musculus flexor digitorum profundus, and one tendon of musculus flexor pollicis longus. And these H tendons, four from superficial and another four from deep flexor, surrounds with the help of synovial vagina. And name of this common synovial vagina is vagina synovialis communis musculorum flexorum of flexor muscles. Common synovial vagina of flexor muscles. And another synovial vagina for tendon of flexor pollicis longus. Vagina synovialis tendinis musculus flexoris pollicis longus. Look here. That is thumb. That is index. That is middle finger. That is ring finger and little finger. That is hand. It is retinaculum flexorum. And under this retinaculum, we have tendon of flexor pollicis longus, and this tendon has synovial vagina, which continues from forearm to hand. We have common synovial vagina to all flexors, but this common synovial vagina finishes below of retinaculum flexorum and continues only to little finger, this one. And these three fingers has its own synovial vagina on palmar surface. And this fact that synovial vagina or common synovial vagina continues only to little finger and not continues to index, middle and ring finger help to receive when you give blood from fingers, which finger used usually?
The
ring finger, usually ring. But the same possible to take blood from middle finger and the same possible to take blood from index finger, but never used little and never used thumb. Why? Because if infection come to little finger or thumb, in this case this infection can spread along of synovial vagina to forearm, and you receive inflammation not only in the region of finger, but inflammation of hand and forearm. It is dangerous for function of upper extremity. But if infection come to in these three fingers, it is the same, not good, but infection will spread only in the region of finger, not continues to hand and to forearm. That is better. If necessary to compare what is better, it is better that infection in the region of one finger than infection not only in finger but with a hand and forearm. Yes. And last, under the retinaculum extensorum on dorsal surface, it is dorsal surface, that is retinaculum extensorum, and it is we have six canals. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six canals under the retinaculum extensorum. And in first canal, we have two tendons. Tendon of musculus abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis. In second canal, extensor carpi radialis longus and extensor carpi radialis brevis. In third canal, extensor pollicis longus. In fourth canal, musculus extensor digitorum, four tendons, and musculus extensor indices. In fifth canal, extensor digiti minimi, and in sixth canal, extensor carpi ulnaris. Once again, you not need to draw this diagram, but you will answer walls of axillary cavity, triangles, two foramen, grooves on and canal, no, which grooves? Sulcus bicipitalis medialis, sulcus bicipitalis lateralis, canalis humeral muscularis, three grooves on forearm, sulcus radialis, sulcus medianus, and sulcus ulnaris, and three canals under the retinaculum flexorum, and six canals under the retinaculum extensorum. That is topography of upper extremity. Any questions? That is all.